Smart Wargames hier. Let's check out John Tiller's campaign series. Or the campaign series itself. This is a series you can find on Matrix. There was one release called John Tiller's campaign series, including World War II, Eastern, Western, and Pacific Front, but there is also one without the John Tiller name tag, focusing on Middle East, post World War II, and an upcoming campaign series, Vietnam. This video here will focus about this and show you a bit so you have an idea about this game. Let's get into it. Yes, you can play single scenarios, edit maps and order of battles, which might be interesting. I'm always a fan of campaigns, so I will focus on this. But order of battle editor. Let's check out what this is. Yeah, whatever. Let's check out a campaign. Yeah, I've already tested a bit. Let's begin a new one. This game comes with really a ton of campaigns. Yeah, it already mentioned that the OOB editor will take a lot of time to open up. The sound is working. Yeah, so what is this OOB editor? Okay, looks good. Always great when you can. Yeah, this is a big editor. Okay, but let's return to the game. Yeah, here is the campaign list, a lot of operations, however. Not exactly sure how good the campaigns are. Sometimes I must say the John Tiller games are a bit behind when it comes to immersion and detailing campaigns. However, one thing that is really great, I will show it to you, is that you can select that's the Eastern Front. However, this game comes also with the Western Front. Yeah, it seems it were three separate releases put together into one compilation. Yeah, same stuff, but we will check out the campaigns. And yeah, different campaigns. Let's say we want to play, there are campaigns where you can decide which country to play, but also on which command level. I will talk about this. This is really interesting. But there are also campaigns like, I don't know, Piper, where you are focused on one command level and on one country. Perhaps those campaigns come with more immersive and atmospheric elements, more quality campaign experience. As you know, I'm not the biggest fan of generic campaigns. Or simply generated campaigns. But you can select this, for example, and you can play this game on different levels. I can show you how it looks like if you want to play on corps, on core level, which might be the biggest level. Yeah, we have some historical information. At least this is good. You can designate your leader, can decide which unit to lead, and then the game will generate the organization for you to command. Yeah, we are Lieutenant General. And don't be, what you will see now is really the hardcore mode. We selected core command level. This is basically the highest you can go in this game. Again, this game has two visions, this 3D miniature vision, figurine vision, and you see already the amount of units might be crazy. You will especially notice it when we go into the 2D mode. Yeah, this is every blue unit is a German unit. Yeah, but I just want to show you what you can go into if you want. You can command a complete core down to the, what is the smallest unit, I guess, platoon squad level. Yeah, platoon level it seems. Yeah, this is a complete core. Which gives you an idea of what, how the heck, how crazy this clashes were. And yeah, sure, perhaps you can assist yourself with AI. However, I will now switch back. You can play the same campaign Ardennes. Yeah. Spearhead into the Ardennes. You can also play it on battalion level. And take a look at the difference. Give me some tigers, why not? As you see, this is quite a big difference. Now you have, yeah, vehicles are represented in a single, and infantry I think is somewhat platoon size or depending, I guess. Special teams like mortars are also modeled, and you see this unit amount is completely different. So you can play really the tactical hardcore. I want to command everything. Or you can go back. Yeah, to the gameplay, I mean, this, if you played one John Tiller game or if you watched my channel, be it, I guess, a game that could be somewhat similar. It is not exactly, there are differences from the functionality I can show you also. The menus, which gives you an idea, so for example you can launch human wave attacks and... But the basic principles are similar to other John Tiller games, and I would say this game is somewhat comparable to Panzer campaigns. Yeah. We have some tigers here, and then you simply can move them around. I think we are in the setup. We are in the setup phase. Yeah. Most hotkeys work. Yes, I can show you the other front line, the last front line, which is the Pacific War. And wait, yeah, about the display options. We already talked about this. Manual. Japanese special rules, so. Looks like a decent manual. And yeah, I think I already shown all campaigns as of the Western Front. Yeah, scenarios, I think they are they generated? No, okay. Yeah, I won't show you everything, but for the people who like single scenarios here, you have a selection. Yeah, it comes definitely with a lot of content. I guess these are the free releases together with, I don't know, expansion packs and add-ons together tied up. Yeah, come on, I need to stop. It isn't stopping. The list is extremely long, as you see. Perhaps it isn't repeating. But you might find every... Let's check the last... game, which is the Pacific Front. Britain, yeah, I think China, all this, also, so China somewhere. US. What? Invasion America? Yeah, this is also interesting. Japan is in a position to invade the US. Okay, let's check it out. Not often seen this option. Sure, it is really unlikely, but why not? Let's go. I want to capture Aberdeen. Yeah, similar thing, you have the 3 division, and this campaign is focusing on regimental or battalion level, which isn't that hardcore from the unit sizes, as you see. Yeah, but 3 division, you can also play in the 2 division if you prefer it. It is resolution tight. Yeah, I think this should give you an overview for combat or whatever. You can check the Panzer campaigns, games I did or whatever. And yeah, that's it. I'll check out another game.